Hey, this is Nancy Ellen with A Crafty Yarn Barn. Today I'm going to show you how to make the half double crochet stitch. In the US, it's referred to the half double crochet stitch. In the UK, it's referred to the half treble crochet stitch. I just have some generic worsted weight yarn. I have an eye, 5.25 millimeter hook, and I have some scissors. That's it. So let's go ahead and get started and making the half double crochet stitch. First, we make our slip knot to put on our crochet hook. I like to leave about a 4 to 5 inch tail when doing my slip knot. I take the yarn tail in one hand and I wrap it around my first two fingers. That yarn tail, I push it through the back of the loop that's on my fingers. I pull my fingers out and then grab a hold of that little loop that I've pushed through. I grab the yarn tail and the yarn that's hooked to my skein and I just pull it tight. This loop that we just made is going to go right onto our yarn hook, our crochet hook. If you grab that tail and you pull that tail tight, that slip knot will slip right up onto, tightly onto your crochet hook. Don't do it too tight. You want it to be able to slide back and forth on the shaft of your crochet hook. Now we're going to make our foundation chain. We're going to chain 10. 8 of those chains will be your foundation, and the last 2 will be actually your turning chain. That will be the side posts for row 1 going back down, and I'll show you that in just a moment. So let's go ahead and do 10 chains. We're going to take our hook, we're going to put it underneath the yarn, we're going to turn our hook downward, and we're going to pull it through the loop that's on our crochet hook. That's chain 1. We take our hook, we go underneath the yarn, we turn our hook downward where it catches into that groove, and we're going to chain 2. Underneath, turn it, pull it through the loop on our hook, that's chain 3. So let's go ahead and chain 10 total. It's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now to do our half double crochet stitch, we're going to put our stitch into the third chain from the hook. So skip this one, that's 1, 2, 3. This is where we're going to put our stitch. We're going to yarn over, that means put the yarn underneath the hook, turn your hook, and we're going to put the tip of the hook through the third chain from the hook. Now we're going to yarn over and pull that yarn through that the top of that foundation chain. We're going to pull it through. And now we have 3 loops on our hook. We're going to yarn over and we're going to pull the yarn through all 3 loops that are on our hook. So we're going to go underneath, turn our hook downward, and we're going to pull it through all 3 loops that are on our hook. That's your half double crochet stitch. Now we go into the next chain on our foundation. See the top loop there? We're going to yarn over and put our hook through the top of that loop. We're going to yarn over, pull that yarn through that foundation chain loop. You have 3 loops on your hook. You're going to yarn over and pull it through the top 3 loops on your hook, leaving only 1 left. Let's go ahead and walk through it one more time pretty slowly. Now we're going to do the next stitch into the next foundation chain. We're going to yarn over. We're going to take our hook and stick it through the top loop of that next foundation chain. Now we're going to yarn over and pull that yarn through that foundation chain loop. That gives you 3 loops on your hook. Now you're going to yarn over and you're going to pull this yarn all the way through all 3 loops on your hook. And I'll go slowly and show you as I work down the foundation chain so you can get the hang of the stitch. We're going into the next chain and we're going to pull our yarn through that loop of the chain. Now we're going to yarn over and pull it through all 3 loops on our hook. Go all the way down and I'll show you how to make your turn for your first row. This is one of my favorite stitches. Now that was my last chain on my foundation. Now we're going to turn our work. Now we're going to chain two. Remember, that's your turning chains. That's the post, the first stitch on the side of your post of your row. Now we're going to start row two. Now we're going to put, when we yarn over and put our yarn through the stitch, we're going to put it through the very top of this, the last half double crochet stitch on row one that we made. These are our turning chains. We're not going to crochet into those. That's the side of row two. We're going to take our yarn and then we're going to put our crochet hook through the very top of that last stitch on row one. When we put our hook through, you're going to be able to see the pattern of those stitches. It's like a V, and you'll know that you go through both of those when you see that V on the top of your hook. Now we're going to grab our yarn and pull it through, and we're going to have three loops on your hook. You're going to yarn over and pull it through all three loops that are on your hook. You're going to go into the next stitch. You can see the hole there. You can see the V pattern all the way down. We're going to take our yarn, go underneath, put it through the top of that stitch. We're going to yarn over and pull it through, and then we're going to yarn over and pull it through all three loops on our hook. Go underneath our yarn, go into the next top of the next stitch, and we're going to pull our yarn through and yarn over and pull it through all three loops on our hook. And I'm going to go ahead and go down the row slowly so that you can see how I work those stitches in. You're going to yarn over, put it through the top of the next stitch, yarn over, and then you're going to yarn over and pull it through all three loops on your hook. And you're going to go all the way down to the very last stitch on the row, and we're going to make our turn. And this is the last stitch. You're going to go underneath, and the very last stitch is a little awkward, so you need to make sure you're putting it through the top of that stitch and you're getting both loops on there, the both loops of that top of that stitch. You're going to yarn over and pull it through, and then yarn over and pull it through all three loops on your hook. Now you're going to turn your work and go back the other way. You need to chain two, and you're going to do your first stitch into the top of the very last half double crochet on row two. Don't work it into the chains. Go underneath the yarn and put it through the top of that stitch. Now I'm going to work it slowly all the way down the row so that you can watch, and then I'll show you how to fasten off your work. Go underneath, put it through the top of the loop, and you're just going to pull it through all three loops on your hook. And you're just going to continue that all the way down the third row. Remember, it's the same stitch pattern all the way through. And when you get to the end of each row, your turning chains, there's two turning chains, for half double crochet for the US or the half treble for the UK. And once you get to the very end, just make sure you're putting it through the last stitch and it goes through the top loop of that last stitch. It can be a little awkward. And then to fasten off your work, you leave about a 4 to 5 inch tail. You yarn over and you pull that yarn tail all the way through that loop, and you gently pull it snug and tight, and that's how you fasten off your work. There's your little swatch half double crochet. This is one of my favorite stitches to do for blankets and for scarves. It's really quick. You can crochet up that really quickly if you need a quick project to do. And look how it's a sturdy little stitch, and look how you don't have much spacing in between there, between those stitches. It's not as small as a single crochet. You get a little bit more height out of it than a single crochet. You don't have as much spacing between there as the double crochet stitch. So this is one of my favorite stitches to do for quick little projects. So tune in and see more videos to come. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe and comment down below. Check out the crochet group on the Facebook, and any of your projects that you're making, Be sure to share those so we can see what you're doing. Happy crocheting, and I'll see you soon. Bye.